Welcome to a video on how to remove a background from an image using Adobe Express. To get to Adobe Express, open up Edge. It will automatically populate with four tabs in the Edge browser. The third tab is Clever. All teachers and students have access to Clever in CCPS. If you have not already favorited Adobe Express on your Clever homepage, teachers would like to go to the district page, and students and teachers can then scroll down through all of the apps, and you will find Adobe Express in the bottom supporting section. Select the heart to favorite Adobe Express, and it will remain at the top of your Clever homepage. Once you've done that, select Adobe Express to open up that app, and you'll find a pink circle with a plus sign in the top left. Click that pink circle and then select Remove Background. When you select Remove Background, you'll have two options: to drag and drop an image or to browse on your device. I always choose Browse on Your Device. If you have images on your device, you can select those images. I'm going to select this one of a Bitmoji of me with a white background, and I'm pointing with a foam finger. I want to get rid of that white background. So I'm going to select that image, click open, and Adobe Express will pretty much automatically remove the background. You can see now it's a transparent background with the same image of me pointing as a Bitmoji with that foam finger. So download that Bitmoji or whatever the image is that you're removing the background from into Adobe Express. What I recommend you do next is change the file name, because the default in Adobe for all new projects is My Project. So I'm going to call this one Bitmoji pointing transparent. So now it has a file name that I'm going to recognize. I'm going to download it. You have PNG, PNG transparent background, JPEG, and PDF. A PDF is not an image file. PNG and JPEG are image files, but we want the one with a transparent background. So select PNG, and when you download something in Adobe in Edge, you'll notice you'll have this window pop open. When I download something in Edge, I always want to click on the folder to find out where it is, and then maybe move it to a folder where I would like to place whatever it is, the file that is I'm saving. So I want this Bitmoji transparent background in this Adobe folder so I know where the file is. It's always smart to put a file in a folder where you can remember where you saved that file. So now that I have that Bitmoji with me pointing with a transparent background on my computer, I can put it into any project, and students can do the same thing. So I happen to have a PowerPoint already open. So I'm going to open up this PowerPoint, and this is a slide that already has an image on it. And in that image, I actually have an image of George Washington and of Alexander Hamilton, although that's me dressed up as George Washington and Lin-Manuel Miranda as Alexander Hamilton. Both of those were images where I removed the transparent background. What I would like to do is insert the Bitmoji of me pointing. So I'm going to click Insert, Pictures, This Device in PowerPoint. I'm going to find that Bitmoji of me pointing with the transparent background. This was the file name, Bitmoji pointing transparent background. So I'm going to select that file and I'm going to insert it. It's really small, so I'm going to have to make it larger because I want that Bitmoji of me pointing at this question. This is a way that students and teachers can make their images more interactive and fit personal style, and also personal images and objects on top of or overlaid on other objects. So we have, this is me pointing at the question that might be asking students in class of how does this whole scene represent Alexander Hamilton's role and his vision during the Constitutional Convention, where we have George Washington sitting back and presiding over the Constitution, but in front of him is Alexander Hamilton, who's holding court behind a podium. That podium also I inserted into this image. It was not located in Philadelphia where Independence Hall is. I used the online search tool in PowerPoint and then put Alexander Hamilton behind it. So this is a way that you can really make images interactive, or videos, or any other thing that a project might be that students and teachers are making, using the Remove Background tool in Adobe Express. Hope you found this video helpful. Adobe Express has lots of tools that are wonderful for student and teacher creation.